Hello friends and everyone, you're welcome back to your Netcode-Hub channel. In this video, we're going to talk about how to pass data from parent component to child component. Let's have a look with an example by using product. I have my Visual Studio open. I have a Blazor server application created. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to create a model, and that's going to be for product. I'm going to have product ID, product name, and product description for the product list. So I'll click on Solution Explorer, and I'm going to add a new class to this. And now this is going to be for product. So I have this for product, and I have the ID, I have name, and I have description. Okay, now I'm going to use this index. So pages index component as the main component here. And I'm going to use maybe this counter for product detail. So let's rename this as product detailed. So this is a product detail component. And now this index here is going to be for product list. Okay, so we have the two components here created. All right, the next thing that we're going to do here is we're going to populate this product list. Okay, and you know, when you come to this product list page here, we're going to have create a code. And now we're going to create a list of products, and we're going to populate it here. So in here, we're going to create a list of products. And we're going to populate it here. So when the page initializes, we populate this product with three products here. So you can see we have the first one, and that is the second, and then the third. Okay. So this is a list of the products. As soon as we call this method, we have three data in here from this product list. So let's work on the product details. So when we click on solution, you can see we have this product details, and in here, when the page loads, we use this card and we display the card title for product name, the card body for product description, and now you can see we have the card footer as a button, and you can see we have it as a bar. Okay, so this we can have a class, so btn, maybe btn danger. And we have it over there as a button here. Okay. Now, when you come to the code session, you want to have something like this, whereby we can have the object of the product for a single product. And now these are all parameters. So they are going to be accepted in. So from this, we're going to accept the product in when the page loads. Like when we call this method, we have to pass in this product as a parameter, and also this method here. As show by button as also a parameter here, so it's going to be either true or false. Okay, now when this button is clicked, this is what you want to do. So do something when this button or buy button is clicked, and we can do that over here. So this buy, you can just copy this, and we can have a C# code here as at onClick. Then we can call this method. Okay, so that is a buy. So now we have this, you know, when we call this method or when you call this component, it is accepting this product as a parameter. It is also accepting this bool here. That's a boolean as what? A parameter as well. So you need to provide two parameters here. Okay, now this is what you're going to do. When we come to this product list page, here we want to display the list of products here. So we're going to clear everything. Now let's paste in this. So this is what you're doing. We are going to loop through this product list here. That is a product that we have here. Now when we loop through, we are calling this product. So this is a child component that we are calling over here. And you know, product here is a parameter. If you check here, it's a parameter that we initialize it here. When you check this product detail, this is a parameter. And you know, this also show button or show by button is also a parameter. So we can also call that button or that parameter over here. And now this is a Boolean, so it is accepting either true or false. We can pass in true. Now when it comes to this product details, we can do something like, so we can just, with this card footer, let's display this here. And now we can just have a look at, so at if, okay, then we say show buy button. So if this is true, then we want to display this button. So as soon as you pass in that parameter, and if it is true, then display this button. All right, so let's save this and let's run this again and see what we have now. All right, so you can see we have them over here. We have this button, they are set to true, and we have the product displayed over here as the card. So if you actually check the main, you can see we have nothing in here from this product list. We are just looping through it and calling this chart component, and now you're passing that data to the chart component. All right, so that is the way to do it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'm going to catch you up in the next video.